I wanna hear you say that you only want me. After 8 years, it was about time for a revolution. Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to the all-new Audi A1 Sportback. Unlike its predecessor, we only get 5 doors with the new A1. Some say that this car is a bit of a luxury Volkswagen Polo. Well, this luxury Polo is looking pretty good, but let's hop in and see what the new A1 is all about. Yeah, this is what it's about.
So for quite some time, Audi has been changing the way it is naming its models. Audi claims that displacement is no longer important because the emphasis is being put on hybrid and electric cars. So how exactly do we read this? A1 Sportback TF SI 30. Is it a 3-liter beast? Well, not quite. Divide it by 3 and you have your answer. Yes, this is a 1-liter petrol engine. Watch the mercury,
see it rising high. Nobody likes curves anymore because it is all about sharp lines. Whether you're a hatchback, an SUV, a saloon, and this is exactly the direction Audi has taken with their new A1. The car has lost all its curves, it gained a bit of sharpness, a bit of maturity, especially with this aggressive front and LED lighting. I really like the look of this car, and it now resembles all the other older siblings from Audi family. Spreading like a virus to the
corners of your mouth. Okay, let's talk about driving dynamics. How does it feel to drive the A1? Actually, really good, nice and easy. Because of its small size, the car feels actually quite nifty. The steering is light but precise. The engine pumps 116 horsepower, 200 newton meters of torque. 0 to 100 is 9.4 seconds, and the maximum speed is just over 200 kilometers an hour. And believe me, you don't want to go any faster in this car. Just keep it steady.
We shall now demonstrate how it feels to be a passenger in the new A1. So I've adjusted both seats for my height, which is 1.7 meters, 5.6. Decent amount of legroom, decent amount of headroom. Third person, well, you've got this big, thick panel in the middle. So if you don't like somebody, you put them right here. That'll be a lovely place to spend some time in the middle.
But for a 3-liter turbocharged engine, it actually sounds quite civilized. That is if you cruise calmly. Because when you want to fly out of a junction like Superman, well, don't get ahead of yourself, because there's a slight bit of a delay before things start to kick in. When you put your foot down, give it a bit of a shove, it does become a little bit rough and noisy, but on the motorway it is very quiet and, quite frankly, well, rather perfect. You can't fault the driving dynamics there. Just like porcelain, we are
broken and put together again. Oh. Boot space, let's take a look at you. We've got an increase of 65 liters, which brings us to a total of 335 liters. Plenty of room to carry all your clutter. And on to interior. It is quite lovely in here, and in full spec, rather impressive. Audi style steering wheel, love it. Large touch screen. The system itself is very easy to use, straightforward. Everything is crystal clear. Let's be honest, the Germans know how to build the best infotainment systems in the world. Something, for example, Japanese well have difficulties with. We've got this neat phone charger, wireless. Since I've purchased a new iPhone, this has been very convenient for me. But it is not all red roses in here, is it? Because as soon as you touch the plastic, the spell has been broken. Although interesting colors and structure, the quality is less than perfect. The hard plastic, cheap and nasty, especially on the side of the doors. It does scratch very quickly as well. Never mind. Good news, you get the digital instrument here. They look fantastic and they come as standard in A1. The seats, they're lovely, although you are sitting quite high up. Overall, it's not bad, but it could have been better.
We've got a 7-speed automatic transmission and everything is smooth and seamless, but there's one weakness. As you start up and get things moving, do expect a little bit of a pull, you know, just to give you a bit of that tinkle in the morning. What about the ride quality? So the S-Line comes exclusively with a sport suspension, and it does feel quite stiff and quite firm, even in the comfort mode, especially that I'm riding on 17-inch wheels. At lower speed, it tends to get quite fidgety on a bumpy road, but as soon as you pick up a little bit of speed, a bit of that momentum, things do settle down very, very quickly. So moral of the story is keep on moving, don't slow down. What about handling on a twisty road like this one? Actually, really good. I'm quite impressed. The car doesn't lean, it doesn't bend. It feels very much planted, very confident, sensible. Very German, you see. The visibility here is really good. You're seeing everything there is to see. And onto a very good point, and that is the petrol consumption. All I'm using is less than 6 liters. Now, that's quite incredible, if you ask me. And this is really, when we're talking about reducing the cylinders, well, actually here, it made some sense. Still prefer a bit more cylinders. But how much is it going to cost you to bond with this confident German? Well, the base price of the A1 in Switzerland is just under 33,000 Swiss francs, which is more or less an equivalent to the US dollar. The model I have admitted to die has added some bits and pieces, and the price has skyrocketed to a whopping 51,000. 51,000! I mean, 51,000! Really, Audi, what on earth? Didn't you just get carried away this slightly? I think you have. I mean, it's a cute car, that expensive. And it is, yes, a bit of a luxury Polo. Sorry, Audi, but that's the reality. Just to give an idea, the S3 with 300 horsepower and a solid quattro versus front-wheel drive is worth 56,000. Yes, I always say different horses for different courses. I am definitely the S3 type. And this brings me to the end of this video. I'd like to thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed it. A big thank you to Catherine and Dieter from Audi Switzerland for lending me this car. As always, I look forward to your comments and your questions. I wish you a wonderful day, whatever that you're doing. And I shall see you all very, very soon. Bye.